हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडेज टॉपिक इज पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। लेट अस सी द डेफिनेशन ऑफ ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। ट्यूबरकुलोसिस इज अ पोटेंशियली फैटल कंटेजियस डिजीज दैट कैन अफेक्ट ऑलमोस्ट एनी पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी बट इज मेनली एन इन्फेक्शन ऑफ द लंग। इट इज डिराइव फ्रॉम अ न्यू लैटिन वर्ड ट्यूबरकल विच मीन्स राउंड नोड्यूल और स्वेलिंग एंड ओसिस इज कंडीशन। द पॉजिटिव ऑर्गेनिज्म इज माइकोबैक्टीरियम ट्यूबरकुलोसिस इन ह्यूमन बींग्स एंड माइकोबैक्टीरियम बोविस इन एनिमल्स। ट्यूबरकुलोसिस कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इंटू पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस एंड एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस कैन फर्दर क्लासिफाइड और डिवाइडेड इंटू प्राइमरी डिजीज एंड सेकेंडरी इन्फेक्शंस। एंड एक्स्ट्रा पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस कैन बी लिम्फ नोड ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, प्लूरल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, टीबी ऑफ अपर एयरवेज, स्केलेटल ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, जेनिटो यूरिनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, मिलियरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस, पेरिकार्डियल टीबी, गैस्ट्रो इंटेस्टाइनल टीबी, ट्यूबरकुलस मेनिनजाइटिस एट्सेट्रा। हाउ ट्यूबरकुलोसिस स्प्रेड्स? इट इज ए ड्रॉपलेट इन्फेक्शन। सो इफ ए पर्सन कफ्स विदाउट कवरिंग द माउथ एंड ही इज इन्फेक्शस देन ही कैन स्प्रेड ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। क्राउडेड प्लेस इज ऑल्सो अनदर फैक्टर बिकॉज इन क्राउडेड प्लेस देर इज मोर चांस ऑफ गेटिंग इन्फेक्शन बिकॉज पीपल दे आर सिटिंग क्लोजली इन ए पर्टिकुलर प्लेस। देन इफ देर इज द हैबिट ऑफ स्पिटिंग एवरीवेयर देन इट कैन ऑल्सो स्प्रेड द ट्यूबरकुलोसिस। वॉट आर द साइन एंड सिम्टम्स ऑफ ट्यूबरकुलोसिस? द सीवियर सिम्टम्स आर परसिस्टेंट कफ, चेस्ट पेन, कफिंग विथ ब्लडी स्पूटम, शॉर्टनेस ऑफ ब्रेथ, यूरिन डिस्कलरेशन, क्लाउडी एंड रेडिश यूरिन, फीवर विथ चिल्स एंड फटीग। बेस्ड ऑन द टाइप ऑफ टीबी द सिम्टम्स ऑफ ट्यूबरकुलोसिस कैन ऑल्सो बी समराइज एज फॉलोज। लाइक इफ अ पर्सन हैज़ पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस द पर्सन विल एक्सपीरियंस प्रोडक्टिव कफ, पुअर एपेटाइट, नाइट स्वेट्स, फीवर, वीकनेस, वेट लॉस। इफ द पर्सन हैज प्राइमरी पल्मोनरी ट्यूबरकुलोसिस ही विल हैव वीकनेस, फीवर, ड्राई कफ, वेट लॉस, नाइट स्वेट्स एंड पुअर एपेटाइट। इफ ए पर्सन हैज ट्यूबरकुलस प्लूराइटिस दैट मीन्स द प्लूरल surface is involved then the person will have dry cough, fever, cough with increasing mucus then the person can cough up blood. Then in case of extrapulmonary tuberculosis the common signs are or common sites sorry common sites will be meninges, lymph nodes, bone and joint and genitourinary tract. Let us now see the pathogenesis of tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is a droplet infection. When a person inhales the infected droplets, then the bacteria mixed with droplet, it will reach the lung. Then in the alveoli, the macrophages, alveolar macrophages will engulf those bacteria. But the macrophages will not be able to digest the bacteria and the tubercular bacteria will multiply inside the macrophages. After some time, there will be formation of granuloma. Granuloma is a mass, it is a type of lesion or it is a mass of लाइव एंड डेड बैसिलाई एंड इट इज सराउंडेड विथ सराउंडेड बाई अ वॉल ऑफ मैक्रोफेज. दैट ग्रैनुलोमा विल बी फॉर्म्ड इन साइड द लंग. ग्रैनुलोमा इफ द बैक्टीरिया सीजेस और इट फेल्स टू ग्रो देन दैट लीजन और ग्रैनुलोमेटस लीजन विल कैल्सिफाई इन 95% ऑफ केसेज. आफ्टर कैल्सिफिकेशन देर विल बी नो इन्फेक्शन अनलेस एंड अंटिल द इम्यूनिटी इज लो. इन केस ऑफ ग्रैनुलोमा विच लिक्विफाइज देन दैट ट्यूबरकुल बैसिलाई आइदर इट विल स्प्रेड टू अदर ऑर्गन्स. इट विल स्प्रेड वाया ब्लड एंड रीच टू अदर ऑर्गन्स causing extrapulmonary tuberculosis and also when the person coughs out then the bacteria will be present in the sputum. This is the pathology behind tuberculosis. Let us see the diagnostic tests involved in tuberculosis. First, AFB test, acid fast bacilli test, which uses the stain Zeal Nielsen stain. Second is culture test. The sputum can be cultured to diagnose tuberculosis with the help of culture. It will take a long time. There are some of the common mediums which are used as a culture are Lowenstein-Jensen solid medium, liquid medium, and agar medium. Test is also done with the help of chest X-ray. In case of tuberculosis, there will be calcification and it is seen in the chest X-ray. Then nucleic acid amplification is also one of the new tests which is done to diagnose tuberculosis, especially extrapulmonary tuberculosis. It is useful for the rapid confirmation of tuberculosis. Example of nucleic acid amplification test is PCR. Tuberculin skin test or Montaux test is also done to diagnose tuberculosis. In tuberculin skin test, injection of fluid into the skin of lower arm. Intradermally, the fluid is injected into the lower arm. After 48 to 72 hours, that site is checked for a reaction, and diagnosis is based on the size of the wheal. Tuberculin test interpretation, the results are as follows. If the wheal size is less than 6 mm, then it can be called as negative. If the lesion is around 6 mm, is 6 mm but less than 15 mm, then the person is hypersensitive to tuberculin protein. It may be due to previous TB infection, BCG, or exposure to atypical mycobacterium, and that person should not be given BCG. If that size of the wheal is more than 15 mm, then a person is strongly hypersensitive to tuberculin protein. It is suggestive of TB infection or a disease. Other biological examinations are cell count, lymphocytes in tuberculosis, neutrophil is high, lymphocyte is low, and some protein tests are also done. If the person has abdominal tuberculosis with ascites, then these protein tests are done. If pleural effusion is there with pulmonary tuberculosis, then also protein test is done. How we can prevent tuberculosis? As it is a droplet infection or airborne infection, simple things what we can do in the community is we have to maintain personal hygiene. That means cough etiquettes should be followed by putting a handkerchief around the mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing. Then routine immunization of a newborn with BCG. Next, taking a nutritious diet, adequate rest, no to alcohol or smoking, and the environment should be clean, and we have to avoid crowded place. So to summarize the preventive measures, use of a mask, BCG vaccine, very important, regular medical follow-up, then isolation of a patient with active tuberculosis, ventilation is very important, natural sunlight and UV germicidal irradiation helps to reduce the bacterial load. BCG vaccine is very effective and it is the only vaccine available today for the protection against tuberculosis. It is most effective in protecting children from the disease, given 0.1 ml intradermal. The duration of protection is around 15 to 20 years. Efficacy can be 0% to 80%. In India, it is a part of the universal immunization program. It is given to all healthy infants as soon as possible after birth, unless the child is presented with symptomatic HIV infection. Let us see now the drugs which are used for the treatment of tuberculosis. The first line drugs are isoniazid, rifampicin, rifapentin, rifabutin, ethambutol, pyrazinamide, streptomycin. Second line drugs are cycloserine, ethionamide, levofloxacin, moxifloxacin, gatifloxacin, para-amino salicylic acid, streptomycin, amikacin, capreomycin. Let us see the action of rifampicin. It is a powerful bactericidal drug. It can cross blood-brain barrier, so it can be used in tuberculosis meningitis. It is very effective against persister and dormant bacilli, that is slow growing bacilli are killed with rifampicin. Effective against intracellular bacilli as well as extracellular bacilli. Rifampicin is orally given. It should be taken 1 hour before or 2 hours after food. It is used in combination with other drugs. When a person takes rifampicin, the urine turns red color or orange color. It indicates compliance with the drug. The side effect of the drug is it causes liver damage. It also causes to some extent kidney damage. Next drug is isoniazid. It is also a very powerful bactericidal drug, effective against fast multiplying bacteria, less effective against slow multipliers. It also crosses blood-brain barrier. The side effects are peripheral neuropathy, liver damage, and blood dyscrasias. This drug is also given orally to reduce peripheral neuropathy. Pyridoxine or vitamin B6 is given. Next drug is streptomycin. It is a bactericidal drug. It acts on rapidly multiplying bacilli. It is effective in extracellular environment. There is no action on slow multipliers. Route of administration is IM. The side effect is vestibular damage and renal damage. It is also used as first line drug. Pyrazinamide is also first line drug. It is a bactericidal drug, powerful bactericidal drug. It is active against slow multiplying intracellular bacilli. The side effects include it is hepatotoxic, it causes hyperuricemia. Next drug is ethambutol. It is bacteriostatic. All other drugs First line drugs are bactericidal. This one is bacteriostatic. It is given orally. The side effect is optic neuritis. The drugs are given in following manner. Four drugs are given for continuously for 2 months, and then for 4 months. There are three drugs which are given continuously. That means a total of 6 month duration primary tuberculosis is being treated. For 2 months, the four drugs are HREZ. That means H is isoniazid, R is rifampicin, E is ethambutol, Z is pyrazinamide. And for the next 4 months, HRE, it is given. HRE means H is isoniazid, R is rifampicin, E is ethambutol. In India, to control tuberculosis, DOTS regimen is followed. DOTS full form is directly observed treatment short course. DOTS means that a trained healthcare worker or other designated individual provides the prescribed TB drugs and watches the patient swallow every dose. DOTS increases the compliance of the drug because these drugs are to be taken for a very long duration. So, DOTS treatment, DOTS method of administering the drugs is very effective.